to have the exhibition at the Lemongrove Gallery, which is one of the UK's leading independent fine art galleries. It offers unrivaled original paintings, collectible limited editions, stylish sculptures in luxurious surroundings. And they've just celebrated their 10th anniversary. And I think part of the success of the Lemongrove is that they make great artwork accessible to the mainstream rather than it being a fine art world pursuit. And I'm just so, grateful that they exhibited my work tonight. This style's a fusion of abstract with a focal point of realism. It was really the Renaissance that was the inspiration for this series of paintings, because the Renaissance had such an impact on so many buildings and iconic landmarks in London that I wanted to sort of put it onto canvas, get people to have a second look, if you like, such as Marble Arch and Wellington Arch. People tend to drive past and without realising just what great gems we have. The fusion really was, I would say Leonardo da Vinci was the inspiration. Not that my work is being compared to Leonardo da Vinci, but there was a book by Edward McCurdy called The Mind of Leonardo da Vinci. And in this classic engrossing text, this distinguished historian examines or explores the mind and manifold interests of this great personality of the Renaissance. It traces his travels, explores his philosophical views as well as assessing his art. And it was a great inspiration that he pushed boundaries. And I thought, right, well, I'm going to do something that resembles certain areas of Renaissance in the architecture, and you use abstract as well as an inspiration, as a pushing point, as it were, to fuse the whole look. And I think it's worked very well. The principles and elements of the painting is colour, contrast, textured layers, emphasis on variety. The use of colour contributes to the painting as a whole. I try to create an atmosphere, quite calmness, from the lights of the whites to the intense streaks of striking black. Contrast is used to balance the painting as a whole so that it results in a flowing formation. You go from abstract to reality to abstract, and it all mixes well together. And textured layers certainly adds to the painting, gives it a three-dimensional feel in certain parts, and that's what I try to show tonight.